I had a question. What's the difference between a certified financial firm? I'm just stumbled onto your show versus what you do versus, say, another financial planners. I mean, how do you know what to choose, who to go with? There are so many options. You know, the stockbroker.
Well, sure. Well, let me explain the difference in the investment world. First of all, virtually anybody today can call themselves a financial planner. You can have business cards made up, and people use financial planner, investment advisor, wealth advisor, all kinds of terms, and so on and so forth. Certified financial planner is a designation that is given to folks that, number one, have completed an extensive course of study, usually 2 years, 3 years. You have to have 3 years of internship. You have to get references. You have to pass a two-day exam that has a 50% pass-fail rate. You have continuing education, if I already said that, and a code of ethics. To give you an example of how many certified financial planners there are out there, there's 1.25 million CPAs in the country. There are only 85,000 certified financial planners. So we're kind of a rare breed. And the good news is we have 12 of those folks right here under our roof in Altamont Springs. Now, as certified financial planners, we are legally obligated to work on your behalf as a fiduciary. Brokers do not. Brokers have what's called, when they work with you under current law, they only have to provide to you what's investments that are suitable. Not necessarily in your best interest, but just suitable. And that means do no harm, but that doesn't mean it's the best. As a fiduciary, we are required under law to work with you and provide you the best advice and the best investments based on what we understand your situation to be. And that's a clear distinction. So, and there's a lot of folks on the radio that calls themselves investment advisors, wealth managers, so on and so forth, and that's great, but you need to understand a distinction. Now, one other thing that you may want to know is our firm is what's called CFEC certified. And that is a distinction that's currently granted by fewer than 1% of investment advisory firms in the country. And that is a designation, if you will, that's been granted by the Center for Fiduciary Excellence. And in order to get that, you have to complete a 120-some-page questionnaire. You have to submit yourself to an audit. They come into your office, interview your entire company, your personnel, look at everything that you're doing, your security system, cybersecurity, the disclosures that you give your clients, on and on and on and on and on. And once you got it, then you have to submit yourself to an annual audit in compliance. And we're fortunate to have that. We are a CFEC certified firm. And like I said, there's only 1%. There's about 12,000 investment advisory firms in the country. And there are fewer than 1% of them that have a certified CFEC certification. Thank you, Rodney. So to make a short story long, basically that's the difference. Look for a certified financial planner. First of all, and then secondly, we'll look for a firm that has been CFEC certified. And that's a distinction. And, you know, we can't guarantee your returns, but what we can guarantee you is a fair shake.
So do they, like other financial planning firms, do they, like, try to buy different bonds and annuities and things for clients versus what do you do? Like, how do you, you know,
how do we work? How do we work with our clients? We work on a fee basis. We don't custody any assets. In other words, if Rodney and I and the firm disappear tomorrow, your money is not on our balance sheet. It's not tied up with our company. We use two major custodians to hold our clients' money, either Fidelity or TD Ameritrade, and that's your assurance. So you get a statement directly from them every month. You can see your account 24/7 on the internet, so we're not pulling a Bernie Madoff on you. And what we become is your advisor. We tell them what to do on your behalf and how to build a portfolio for you to reach your short-term and long-term objectives using no-load, no-commission mutual funds. And we charge a fee for that services. And the fees generally start in the area of 1% on the first $1 million. And it's not a lifetime contract. You can leave us anytime that you want. Most people don't. They stay with us for a lifetime, but there's no lifetime contracts. And basically, that's how we do it. We work on your behalf. We have no house products. This is important, too. There's absolutely nothing with our name on it, which means we can pick and choose from the very best that's out there.